At this time, I'd like to invite Dr. Jeff Weinman and Marco Costanzo to the podium.
Thank you, Karen. A footstep, a door creak, or in the case of 1991's The Silence of the Lambs, the sound of Hannibal Lecter chomping into a prison guard's face in an effort to escape. Not everyone can make a living from the sounds of bones breaking and skulls smashing on pavements. But according to articles in the Wall Street Journal and New Jersey Monthly, it's all in a day's work for Marco Costanzo. To those who know you, you've always been Marco the Magnificent. You have a natural ability to entertain with your creativity and vivid imagination through magic, illusions, and conversation. In all that you do, you aim to deliver joy and amazement to others. With this natural ability to entertain, you've built a hugely successful career as a Foley artist, named after pioneering sound recordist Jack Foley. He was credited with being the first to record sound effects in sync with the actions that you see on the screen. You've amassed more than 500 film and television credits as Foley artist for works as diverse as Hail Caesar, Into the Woods, Foxcatcher, The Wolf of Wall Street, Boardwalk Empire, Shutter Island, Julie and Julia, and Silence of the Lambs. You've said that one of your favorite projects was Life of Pi. To quote you, it presented many unique challenges that I have never encountered. A 30-foot lifeboat with a tiger and orangutan, a hyena and zebra all stomping around in one form or another, a flying fish attack, a floating island with roots for soil and with meerkats as the lifeblood. Pretty wild stuff. You're at your best when a film script describes a sound that conveys an emotion, such as placing a glass down fearfully. Finding the sound which perfectly evokes the emotion emphasized on screen is where the artistry rests. For more than 35 years, you've been part of the New York City post-production community, learning from and working with the finest film, television, and commercial editors, producers, and directors available. Those around you are amazed at how you can take an ordinary object and give it life. You spent hours and hours in the studio with your sound engineer chasing sonic perfection. In fact, you were part of the team that won an Academy Award for sound editing for your work on Martin Scorsese's 2011 film, Hugo, and the HBO series Boardwalk Empire, for which you won two Primetime Emmy Awards. A gifted artist, you've had the opportunity to share your story and demonstrate your talents on shows such as Martha Stewart, CBS Sunday Morning with Charles Osgood, and many others. Over the years, you've performed in countless schools, hospitals, churches, fairs, and summer camps throughout the United States and abroad, and have brought great joy and amazement to underprivileged and ailing children and adults. For your creativity, devotion to your craft, and never-ending ability to entertain, instilling in us, at the appropriate moments, joy, fear, and laughter, Fairleigh Dickinson University salutes you with the Pinnacle. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
I don't get that.
Would you like to make some remarks?
I just want to say I was a little confused walking in here. When I first got word that the Pinnacle Society, that was my first mistake. I thought it was the Pinnacle Society. And I studied up. I didn't know how to play pinochle at the time, but I know that 100 aces is a good hand, and a few other items like that. I'm just thrilled to be here. Thank you all. It's a true honor, and I'm joined by all my friends from college, many of them all Fairleigh Dickinson graduates, and their wives and friends. And it's just thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff, and congratulations, Marco. Silence of the Lambs, I love that movie too.